Greetings, it's Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the Candida range of dietary supplements. Thanks for checking out this video today. This is going to be one of several videos I'm going to do on comprehensive digestive stool analysis. So that's comprehensive stool testing and its relevance with Candida yeast infections. So you may have read some of my articles at yeastinfection.org, or perhaps even looked at my book, Candida Crusher, or maybe even looked at some of my videos, and you'll probably notice that I'm a person who's not really all that interested in just killing Candida as such. I think it's pretty dumb to try and gain harmony in the body by killing anything. It's all about getting balance back in the body again by making it difficult for yeast infections to thrive, by taking foods away that allow yeast to really encourage the proliferation of yeast, actually make Candida grow in the body. And you'll do that by having a big imbalance in your diet, particularly if you like eating lots of sugars, processed foods, candy, ice cream, alcohol, those sorts of things, all those crappy kind of foods, foods that we know that we shouldn't eat. But what about the beneficial bacteria? People talk about taking probiotics. People talk about eating fermented and cultured foods. What about assessing beneficial bacteria? Have you ever thought about that? Assessing the good guys in your digestive system. I think it's very, very relevant. If you've had chronic Candida yeast infection for a long time, it's very smart to have a stool test done. Because a stool test, unlike, many people say, well, why would you do a stool test? Why not do a blood test to look at antibodies? Why not do a urinary test to look at the metabolites, or the organic acids? Well, those tests are okay, but I think stool testing is far more relevant because it gives you a lot more useful information, particularly when I start assessing the beneficial bacteria. So I'm going to read a little bit out of my book here. It's not just about a positive Candida result. What is your level of beneficial bacteria? The other thing I look for in the CDSA test is the level of other bad bacteria, and particularly the level of beneficial bacteria. Is there a 1, 2, or 3 plus of good and or bad? You may be concerned, for example, if you have a positive result with Candida after stool analysis, but have failed to look at the amount of beneficial bacteria, because stool testing also, the people in the lab, the technicians, they actually culture the stool for the good bacteria as well. Now, you may discover that you may have NG or nil growth, and then you may turn around to me and say, well, that's crap. I've been taking these probiotic pills for 6 months or 1 year. I've been taking two or three a day. I've been eating yogurt. I've been having kefir. How come I've got no growth there? I will come to that in a minute. So I want you to remember, it's not all about killing Candida. It's about restoring digestive harmony. And by assessing your level of the good and bad bacteria, as well as yeast, you'll be in a powerful position to restore digestive harmony. No other pathological or functional test can give you this incredible level of balanced information. Now you can see why I believe this to be the Rolls Royce of tests. So if you're serious about getting rid of a yeast infection, get a stool test done, a CDSA. If you go to ericbacker.com, my website, you can click on lab tests. You can actually access one of those through the company I deal with, Direct Labs. I'm quite happy to help interpret this test for you for a fee, naturally, to spend time with you. But many naturopaths or functional doctors will, do this test with you. But make sure, if you've got a chronic Candida infection, to get a stool test done to assess what the heck is going on. Is there inflammation? Are there immune dysfunctions? What are the beneficial bacteria like? Do you have parasites? There's loads of information you can pick up from the stool test. But the beneficial bacteria is very, very important to assess. Be sure to check out yeastinfection.org and do my quiz to see if you've got mild, moderate, or severe yeast infection. And check out my website, Canxida. That's Canxida. Check out canxida.com for really good quality antifungal and a probiotic enzyme supplement. I'm a big believer that if you take probiotics, you take enzymes at the same time. And I'll go into that in a subsequent video. Thanks for checking out my video, and be sure to subscribe to this channel and also check out the other videos I've done. There's quite a few on this channel now that I think you might find of some benefit. Thanks again.